About 6 months ago, when the yellow vest movement started in France, about 5 or 6 months ago, I said that the solution, when I saw the yellow vest and I saw the French Revolution kicking off and the French people starting to identify the problem, which was monopoly and oligarchy, which was a global conspiracy to keep them poor. While the global elites enriched themselves. When I started to see that, I realized that they were onto something. It was the same kind of revelation I had when I saw Occupy Wall Street. Although it was misdirected and it wasn't very organized and no one seemed to really, really understand what the real problem was or how to bring on the change, you could see the power and the message that when people come together, there's something to it. There's something that shakes the foundation, right? And French people are doing it. Right? But right around that time, I threw out a couple of ideas, and I think they're starting to catch on in some way. You know, I saw some evidence of it catching on, right? So, people can bring on the change, right? Right now, in Kabuki theater, right, with Trump and China. That's all fake. That's a fake story. I'll tell you why. But you're seeing this kind of. That's a panic. That's actually a panic mode, right? Trump is enforcing a 25% tariff. He jacked it up 15%. So now Chinese will have to pay 25% on all of their imports into this country, right? It's Trump's attempt to, that's his one trick pony, right? His one big trick is to decrease the, quote, trade deficit, right? To bring our exports and their imports in balance. Right now, we don't export anything to China, very little, right? And they import all their shit to us. So Trump jacked up the debt. And I'll tell you why they do it. It's just, again, kabuki theater. But what I was talking about is that 6 months ago, I talked about the need to for the people to bring on the inevitable crash, the popping of the everything bubble, right? The everything bubble. What a great phrase. I stole that from Zero Hedge, right? The everything bubble. It really is everything, right? It's stocks, It's the derivative markets, it's the equity markets, it's mortgages, it's credit cards, it's student loans, it's debt, right? It's the everything debt bubble, right? That's what it is. So, and I speculated run on the banks, that if people took their money out of the banks, that we can run the banks and freeze. That's one way of bringing it on. Student loans, if you have them, take them, throw them in the garbage. Just cut the paper up. Whatever it is, throw in the garbage, right? And you say, my fucking credit rating. Oh, God damn it, my credit rating. I can't do that. My credit rating is so precious. It's so precious. My name in a computer, my number in a computer is so precious and so important. I'll tell you why it's not important at all. Business loans, just throw them away. Just for the moment, throw all that shit in the garbage and start over. An economic reset. This is what I speculated, right? Any debt, credit cards, mortgages, medical bills, tear them up, throw them out, right? And if all people came to the same conclusion, if we all did it at once, we'd have, of course we'd bring the system to its knees, right? Which is the corrupt Federal Reserve and how money flows into the economy, illegitimately, really, to prop up corporations and make you starve, right? When you debt, you have to pay. When banks debt, they don't pay shit. They get away with it, right? So liquidate your stocks, withdraw your money from the bank, and really, most importantly, is if you're in the military, defect to take away, because the military-industrial complex, in times of crises, don't kid yourself. The United States government will use that military against you. That's why building walls, I'm never a fan of building walls. You build a wall to keep them out, but it really, in times of crisis, it keeps us in. So let's dive into some of the current mania. Trump mania. After much theatrics and 11th hour negotiations, the U.S. more than doubled tariffs to 25% on more than $200 billion in goods imports, good imports from China, just after midnight on Friday, in what has been dubbed the most dramatic step yet in Donald Trump's crusade to extract trade concessions from Beijing, deepening a nearly two-year-old conflict that has roiled global markets and impacted the world's economy, right? Now, it's a big show because there's a lot of things that China can do to reboot that, right? To counteract the trade deficit, right? U.S. has raised tariffs $200 billion from 10% to 25%. China deeply regrets this. But here's some of the things that China might try to do. And then we'll talk about the bigger picture because that's really the subject of this. It's not the China trade deficit because that's, again, it's show, right? It's show. China can place tariffs on the remainder of U.S. goods that haven't been affected yet. By the way, this trade deficit, this trade tariff, won't kick in for another 2 weeks because all goods that have already shipped out of China are not subject to it. It's products that are shipped as of midnight tonight, Friday, New York, U.S. time, right? Okay. So what can China do? Place tariffs on the remaining of U.S. goods that haven't been affected yet or raise existing tariffs 25%. It's not a ceiling, right? I don't know what that means. Devaluating the yen. Well, they'll definitely do that. They can, they're massive, you know, trade. They'll just lower, they'll devaluate their own money, right? And then, so that'll help, right? Either gradually or in one sharp step, as they did in 2015. China could also invoke the nuclear option and dump U.S. securities. Ooh, that would not only kill us, but it would kill them, right? See, that's how, when you watch Venezuela episode, right, and you see the U.S. flexing its muscles against Russia and China and trying to vilify China, China is holding, like, a huge amount of U.S. treasuries. And if they decided to hit the market and dump those treasuries, right, the U.S. would be fucked. We'd be screwed. They'd be screwed, right? They would be killing their biggest customer, right? Would they do that? Well, they could. If you keep pushing them, they may just do it. China could also escalate non-tariff barriers, making it difficult for U.S. inspection processes and more painful, whatever, right? So there's a lot of things that China can do, but here's the big stuff, right? This is all zero hedge reporting, man. I couldn't have said it better, man. You guys are killing it, man. You guys are killing it. Is this guy really a person? Tyler Durden? Is this a person that, you know, I don't even know who the fuck these guys are, right? So the global market, listen to this phraseology, and then we're going to talk about your credit rating and what the master Trump has said in the past about the bubble, right? It's a bubble, right? It's an everything bubble. All these markets are bubbles, right? Ready to pop because they're up too high, right? They're fueled by fake money, right? It's propped up, right? So global stock markets and some treasury markets have become rather speculative farces over the past 10 years. So much so that there are many people in the investment world that actually believe the long-running bull market rally will never end. My view of stock markets has always been the same. They are an economic placebo. A placebo. It's a fake pill. Right? A psychological crush that is exploited by central banks and governments to dupe the public into thinking our financial system is stable, even while the rest of the economy is in deep decline, steep decline. A placebo, it's fake. Right, the markets are propped up by the banks who are propped up by a fake Fed. It's not people buying the market. It's not people buying stocks that's causing the S&P to skyrocket. If you look right now, I'm following it right now. So the S&P, as of this morning, is fine, right? It's holding. But look at the most revealing thing. Again, this is 2008 and all the way up to Obama. And then the crash. This is the crash of Obama. This is Bush. Then Obama gets elected. Crash. Right, run Obama era runs all the way back and surpasses the, it surpasses this level, the high of Bush, makes his own high. Trump comes in, scares the market a little bit, and boom, it takes off again, right? And so here we are over the last year in this roller coaster ride, right? It's still way up at the high, but just recently we were all the way down here at the almost low, right? So you see how the market is very, very volatile right now. This run, and this is what Trump talks about, right? Right here he is, right? You want to hear him say it? It's a bubble.
Mr. Trump,
typical politician. Oops. All talk, no action. Sounds good, doesn't work, never going to happen. Our country is suffering because people like Secretary Clinton have made such bad decisions in terms of our jobs and in terms of what's going on. Now, look, we have the worst revival of an economy since the Great Depression. And believe me, we're in a bubble right now. And the only thing that looks good is the stock market. But if you raise interest rates even a little bit, that's going to come crashing down.
So he says we're in the worst recovery, that the market is a bubble, right? But now he's saying the opposite, right? It's just, this is before the election. Now that he's elected, now he's saying the opposite.
We are in a big, fat, ugly bubble, and we better be awfully careful. And we have a Fed that's doing political things. This Janet Yellen of the Fed. The Fed is doing political by keeping the interest rates at this level. And believe me, the day Obama goes off and he...
So there he's saying that the interest rate at zero is political things. It's holding, it's creating zombie corporations that they take the free money and then they're not profitable, right? They can't sustain their own lives, right? So here's Trump identifying the problem in 2016 when he's running against Hillary Clinton. Whoever told him to say this was accurate in telling him, because Trump... But now he's saying the total opposite, that the market is so powerful, right? So all along he's saying that it's a bubble, it's inflated all the way up to here. Then he gets in, he said, no, it's the opposite, it's fantastic, right? So that's the state of now, right? With Trump. Right, so they are economic placebos, psychological. It's a psychological crutch that is exploited by central banks and the government to dupe the public into thinking our financial system is stable. So Trump was saying he was saying exactly that. Now that he's elected, he's saying no, it's a good thing, right? Stock markets are one false indicator. False indicator. What a great term, right? Haven't heard these terms since Wall Street. Right? Stock markets are one false indicator among a few, such as rigged GDP numbers, right? Rigged inflation, and as well as rigged employment stats. Remember, I did a video on the fact that the government promotes a unemployment rate of 3.7% in the country when it's actually more like 20%. When you actually, it's more, 25%, right? You actually consider all the people that are not working. So all of these numbers are rigged. GDP, rigged inflation numbers, they're all fictitious numbers that don't really matter. They're placebos to keep you quiet, to keep the masses in the dark. There he goes, right in that sentence. At least for a while. In every bubble in modern history, there comes a moment in time when central banks are either forced to let the fraud collapse or they deliberately allow the fraud to collapse. Banks and countries can only fake a recovery for so long, and very often global elitists gain political and social advantage by simply letting the system crash for a time. Central banks started out working in tandem in 2009 to bring about a reversal of the global debt and derivatives crises. Remember, that was the TARP money, $600 billion to bail out the banks. For the that whole thing was stacked on the price of fake mortgages, fake real estate prices, right? And then when it reversed because they were leveraged 40-1, it crashed. After the Federal Reserve began the taper of QE, quantitative easing, other central banks around the world started to do the same. This all came as an abrupt stop in December of last year. Markets are greeted with the unsettling prospect that the Fed was going to back off its policy tightening, back off of its policy tightening, and the interest rates were going to meet the Fed's neutral rate of inflation. I was trying to say something very important about this, and I forgot what I was going to say. But that's really it. It's really all right in this paragraph. Banks and countries can only fake a recovery for so long, and very often global elites gain political social advantage by simply letting the system crash. The everything bubble is about to crash. I think that's what I was trying to say. They also, right, so stock markets, here is. But as well, as with every other market crash of the past century, massive bounces are inevitable, right? That's what you're seeing, that massive bounce. That's what I wanted to say. See this massive bounce? It's a big bounce, right? See this? When it went, boom, it bounced, and then now it's up here, right? So for real traders right now, the short is right here. You sell the shit out of it. Can it continue to go up? It could, but it's, again, if it is going up, it's total fake, right? So the farce was not quite over. While the Fed added a few calming words to its rhetoric, its tightening policies did not change. Plunge protection came from a rather surprising source, China. So China, what we're trying to say is that China is the scapegoat, right? China is the scapegoat, right? They're the when shit hits the fan, right? Right? It's rather than blame, rather you can't blame your own Fed, because Fed usually runs in to save the day. Here I come to save the day. That's what the Fed does. They come in and they try to save the day, and then they blame China. See, China, it's China's fault, right? Rather than look at your own backyard and look at the real problem that the Fed has been inflating this, and our own government has been inflating the problem for so long, now we'll find an enemy, right? With the election, it was Russia. Now with the economy, it's going to be China. Right? Blame China. It's because of the deficit. It's because they won't pay. You know, they won't pay enough to bring this shit into our country, and it's killing us, right? And it doesn't look at our exportation of jobs, the job market, the removal of taxation on corporations. It doesn't look at any of that stuff. So Trump is touting out, tariffs will make our country much stronger, not weaker. Just sit back and watch. Sit back and watch. QAnon. Q. Q. Sit back and watch. Trust the plan. It sounds familiar, right? Sit back and watch. In the meantime, China should not renegotiate deals with the U.S. And then he takes a political stab. This is not the Obama administration or the administration of Sleepy Joe who let China get away with murder. So you heard Trump in his own words, right? Now, let's talk about your credit rating, right? Because everybody's so fearful of the credit. Right? That's the thing that's holding the whole thing together, right? Don't move. Listen, these are some cool commercials.
They say a man should always dress for the job he wants. So why am I dressed up like a pirate in this restaurant? It's all because some hacker stole my identity. Now I'm in here every evening serving chowder and iced tea. Should have gone to freecreditreport.com. I could have seen this coming at me like an atom bomb. They monitor your credit and send you email alerts so you don't end up selling fish to tourists in t-shirts. Well, I married my dream girl, I married my dream girl, but she didn't tell me her credit was bad. So now instead of living in a pleasant suburb, we're living in the basement at her mom and dad's. No, we can't get a loan for a respectable home just because my girl defaulted on some old credit card. If we'd gone to freecreditreport.com, I'd be a happy bachelor with a dog and a yard.
Well, I was shopping for a new car. Which one's me? A cool convertible or an SUV? Too bad I didn't know my credit was whack, because now I'm driving off the lot in a used subcompact FREE. That spells free. Creditreport.com, baby. Saw their ads on my TV. Thought about going, but was too lazy. Now instead of looking fly and rolling fat, my legs are sticking to the vinyl and my posse's getting laughed at. FREE. That spells free. Creditreport.com, baby.
Offer.
Right, so that, you know, I'm just, this is a little tidbit, right? Because a credit rating, right? That's what people are holding on to, right? I said it in the beginning. I'll bring it back up. So there's this big bubble out there, right? The everything bubble. Right? I'm trying to sew a lot of pieces together. So just bear with me. That we do hold the power, although we relinquish our power and our decision making over to the Fed and the bankers and the crooked politicians to make decisions for us, to bring on the change that they want, to, you know, hoodwink us, grab a couple of $1 million for themselves when the collapse comes. It's no big deal because their life doesn't change, right? Someone with $10 billion or $25 million and that did the right thing and stashed a couple bucks in the house, you know, food, whatever, guns, whatever, they take care of themselves, right? Those people are not going to be affected as much in the immediate crash, but people living paycheck to paycheck are going to really be hurting in this kind of crash, right? But the only thing we hold on to is our credit rating, right? Please, 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 please give me more credit. Give me more. All the stuff I have is credit, right? So you're a slave to the bank, right? You're a slave to the bank, and the bank is a slave to the government, who's enslaved to the Fed, who's printing fake money, it's just a big nasty bubble. The only difference is that the fruit of your labor keeps the whole thing going. Let me say that again. The fruit of your labor, when you take a hammer and hammer in nails and build a house and your work keeps the thing going, or you show up on a daily basis to a job, you're the fruit of the labor, right? You control the power. It's the illusion is that the federal government and the economy is controlled by banks and by the Fed, but it's actually you're the power. Right? That's why if you run the banks, if you default on student loans, if you throw business loans in the garbage just for a period of time until we get a reset, take credit cards, throw them in the garbage, mortgages, don't pay. Right, medical bills, don't pay, right? Bring the whole thing down. Liquidate your stocks. Withdraw your money from the bank. Defect from the military so they're not asking you to shoot at, you know, innocent people when the shit comes about. That's how you bring back a citizen. We deflate the bubble. So that was a bit of a ramble. I hope it's clear. I tried to bring some light to what's going on in with this Chinese deficit and all that stuff. It's just bullshit. They're going to either jack up the prices. Their markets are not being affected. Our markets are not being affected. It's all just flex, right? It's all flex at this point, right? We may pay higher prices, but the fact is that the looming debt bubble that's about to pop is really inescapable. I mean, it's historical and it's inescapable, but this time it does look like it's going to get, I mean, we didn't stimulate the economy in terms of making stuff. All the things that Obama said, you remember Obama? We have to work harder and become more industrious and change our professions. Remember when he said all that bullshit in 2008, right? People bought it, right? And none of it has ever kicked in, really. People just go back to sleep, right? And they go back to sleep even harder. They're going back to sleep even harder now than they did, thinking that, I don't know, like you're gonna switch out the swamp, right? The new president is gonna clean the swamp. He's gonna get rid of all the FBI and the CIA guys and all the corruption, you know. And the Democrats are parading, you know, William Barr is the new traitor because he didn't give them their paper quick enough and the redacted version of the Mueller report. That's all bullshit, man. So Marcus Conti reporting. I hope that was stimulating. Stimulate your thoughts on this morning. If you could kindly become a Patreon of this channel, we're just getting started, in my opinion, and or become a one-time contributor on PayPal. You can also go to eBay and buy some stickers. Right? I got the old ones. I got the new ones. All right, so, Mark Scanti reporting. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, too. Thank you.